So after the nuclear fuel has been through full cycle at the nuclear power plant, what do we do with it? First, it goes into storage in the spent fuel pool. Immediately after discharge from the reactor, it's so radioactive that it can actually boil the water in the storage pool. But much of this radioactivity is short-lived, so that after 5 years or so, it's no longer so difficult to handle. Because the DOE has delayed so long with building a repository, the utilities have first had to redesign their storage racks so more fuel could be stored in the pool, and then, when it was full again, move well-cooled fuel to dry storage outside the confinement building. This graph shows how the whole industry is running out of storage pool space and being forced to move to dry storage cask. These dry storage casks are, of course, highly engineered and have to be approved by the NRC before use by nuclear utility. Here is a map of the dry cask storage locations in the United States, and you can see that most of the states on the eastern seaboard have dry storage casks somewhere in the state. Here is a picture taken from the Nuclear Regulatory Commission website that shows what these dry storage casks look like. We'll be right back.